Good afternoon student, now we are going to see about the conditional statement and we will continue this topic because we have seen in our previous lecture about if and if else statement. Now here we will see the program, write a program to find greatest number among three numbers. That means we have to take three input from the user and we will find the greatest number among them. Now see, this is the your program. Now first of all we have to take x equal to int input, enter the value of x. That means we have to take three value from the user and we have to store that value in our three variable like x in y in z. Now we have put declare a variable max1 equal to x, put the value of max1 is equal to x. Now we are going to check the condition. If y is greater than max1, then max1 equal to y. That means if y is greater than max1, then max1 equal to y. If z is greater than max1, then max1 equal to z. Now here we have checked the condition. If y is greater than max 1, अगर y max 1 से बड़ा है then max की वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगी, y हो जाएगी. If z is greater than max 1, अगर z जो है हमारा max 1 से बड़ा है तो max की वैल्यू z हो जाएगी. अदरवाइज हमारी max की वैल्यू क्या होगी, ये x ही रहेगी. Now print maximum number is max 1. Now we are going to check the output by running this program. Now see, first of all we have to input the value of x. Now suppose that we have input 12. Now value of y 22. Now value of z is 5. Now see, our maximum number is 22. Now we will just find out the maximum number and by running this program we have get the maximum number as 22. That's why I hope you have understand this program. First of all we have taken three variables. Now we have assigned the max value to the y, sorry, max value of x into max 1. Maximum number पे हमने x की value रख दिया है, अब maximum को हमने y से compare कर दिया, z से compare कर दिया और वहाँ पे हमने क्या कर दिया है, max की value को print करा दिया है. So this is your simple program to find the greatest number from three numbers. Now our next statement is our if else if and else statement. Now if and if already can be used separated, we are going to use else or we cannot use else. It depend on our program we are going to use else or not. So now we are going to see with the help of a program, write a program to find the grade of a student. Now we are going to find the grade of the student. Then first of all we have to take the input of marks from the user. Then we have take the variable marks equal to int input, enter the percentage of marks. Now we are going to check the condition if marks is greater than or equal to 60. अगर जो percentage marks हमारा 60 से क्या है, बड़ा है या 60 के equal है, 60 के equal है, then print grade is first. Else if अगर ऐसा नहीं है then 60 is greater than marks and marks is greater than equal to 50. That means our marks is less than 60 and greater than or equal to 50. Then print grade is second. That means if our marks is marks percentage is between 50 to 60, then print the second division or second grade. Else if अगर ऐसा नहीं है then else if 50 is greater than marks and marks is greater than or equal to 40. That means if marks is within the range 40 to 50, then print grade is third. Else print failed. That means if the percentage marks is less than 40, then print the student is failed. Now this is the program by using if, else if and else statement. This is the else if is the short form of else if. This is the short form of else if. So don't be confused here. Now running the program. See here, enter the percentage of marks. Suppose that we are going to input the percentage of marks 78. Now print grade is first. Now if we again run this code, and now we will print the take the input as 54, then you can see that grade is second. Now if again we run the program and input the grade as 40, then grade is printed as third. Now if again we have run this program and take the grade as 39, sorry, marks is 39, then print the grade is failed. So we have observed that the program is working in proper way. Now our next topic is nested if. Nested if, that means if within if. We are going to use if statement. If statement within if statement. This sequence is called nested if. Now we will understand with the help of a program. Write a program to print three numbers into ascending order. Now we are going to take three numbers from the user and we will print that number in ascending order. Now see, first of all we have to take the three numbers from the user. Now we will store the value of three numbers into x, y and z. Now we have declared three variables, minimum, mid value and max value equal to none. That means in the first there is no value assigned for minimum and middle and maximum value. Now we are going to check the condition if x is less than y and x is less than z. X क्या है, y से भी छोटा हो गया, z से भी छोटा हो गया है. And if y is less than z, that means if y is also less than z, then minimum, middle and maximum value will be x, y, z. That means in this case we have checked that x is less than y and x is less than z. In this case if x is less than y and x is less than z, then x will be the minimum value. Then we have assigned the minimum of value of h in x. And again in this if, again in this if we are going to check y is less than z. That means if y is less than z, x already minimum पे आ गया है, अब y भी क्या है, z से अगर छोटा हो जा रहा है, if y is less than z, that means middle value will be y and the maximum value will be z. Now we have printed the sequence x, y, z. Else, now this else is the part of this if, not this if. This else is the if, the this if. Else, that means if y is not less than z, else that means y is greater than z. If y is greater than z, that means our middle value will be z and maximum will be y. Then the sequence will be minimum value will be x, middle value will be z and maximum value will be y. So this is the sequence to print the number in ascending order. Again this is the for one condition. Else if, again we have checked y is less than x and y is less than z, and if x is less than z, then minimum, middle, maximum will be y will be the minimum value, x is less than z, that means x will be the middle value and z will be the greatest value. Else, that means if x is greater than z, then z will be the value, middle value, and x will be the greatest value. Now else, this else is the part of this if body. This if, second one is else if, and third one is this is the else body. If, else if, and else. Else if x is less than y, then print minimum value is z, middle value is x, and largest value is y. Else minimum value will be z, maximum value will be x, and middle value will be y. Because if we are going to check this condition, x is less than y and x is less than z, and if x is less than y, then we will find out this order. Z will be the minimum value, and x will be the middle value, and y will be the largest value. Now we are going to print number in ascending order is minimum, middle, and maximum value. Now run this code to check the output. Suppose that we have given value of x is 20, value of y is 23, and value of z is 3. Now you can see that number in ascending order is 3, 20, and 23. Now if we are going to run again this code, you can take any sequence of values. Suppose that x equal to 12, y equal to 54, and z equal to 87. Now your number in ascending order will be 12, 54, and 87. So this is your program. Now your assignment is write a program to print 3 number into descending order. You have to print the 3 number into descending order. Now I hope you have clear understanding of conditional statement. In our next lecture we have see about the some more program based on conditional statement, and after that we will go for looping statement. Now thank you for